Hello, welcome to my channel, Surabhi, and this is the pick a card reading. And in this reading, it is a different reading. It is not for any particular zodiac sign. It is a timeless reading, and you can check this anytime in any sphere of your life. Okay, so in this, what I have done is there are four sets of cards, and each set has three cards. Okay, now you just try to concentrate and just see as to which bundle you are attracted to, or which set of cards you are attracted to. This is set number one, set number two, set number three, and set number four. Okay, again I am repeating 1, 2, 3, and 4. So these are the four sets of cards, and each set has three cards. Okay, so whichever card you are guided to, or whichever card jumps up to you, whichever bundle I should say set jumps up to you, or you're more drawn to, that is how you are supposed to decide as to what is the card or the message for you. Okay, if you feel you are not able to decide, you can pause the video, have a look at the sets, and just concentrate and just see as to which set jumps out to you, or looks more prominent to you, or whichever you are drawn to. So set one, set two, set three, and set four. Okay, so once you decide that whichever set you are drawn to, if you want, you can listen to the messages of all the sets, and if you are drawn to more than one set, that is also fine. And this is the timeless reading, so you can check it anytime. So coming to the messages for those of you who have chosen set number one, coming to the messages in set number one. Okay, you have the Ten of Cups, you have the Chariot, and you have the Knight of Swords. So it is a very very positive energy. It is a very positive card. It is about you have attained a lot of satisfaction and happiness and contentment in whatever you were doing or you are doing in your life. And with the Chariot and the Knight of Swords, what I feel is you are already in a happy position either, and the Chariot of your life is moving forward, or it can be different also for different people, that you the Chariot of your life has started moving forward. There is some opportunity, and you are moving ahead in a sort of a success type of a thing. And if it is a relationship, because here it is a family card also, it is ultimate. If it is a relationship you are moving towards, then you, with the Knight of Swords, if it is a relationship or it is a project, it is a career, whatever it is, you feel like moving very fast into this energy. You just feel like galloping into it. You are just too focused onto it, and you are very passionate about it, moving very fast. But the guidance here is, don't be blinded by focus is right, but not to the extent that you're not even seeing what is in the scenario around. So you're just guided to go a little slow and just weigh the pros and cons as to in whatever direction you are pursuing, be it personal or professional. Okay, but definitely it is something you're very passionate about, you're very happy about. Things are moving very fast in your life. Chariot is also a fast moving energy. Knight of Swords is also very fast moving energy, but Chariot also advises you to balance between the good and the bad. And definitely it is happiness. So it is not that whatever it is very good, very happy. It is going to give you satisfaction. It is a stable energy. It is going to give you 100% satisfaction and happiness. Okay, it can be a personal relationship. It can be a professional situation. Now that you have to decide according to when you meditated on this card, or when this card was drawn to you, whatever question you had in your mind when you were seeing these cards and choosing the cards, according to that you have to resonate this situation. But it is a very good energy. Okay, so this is for the number, those who have chosen number set one. So coming to those who have chosen set two. So those of you who have chosen set two, with the Five of Swords, there is something negative. Definitely you are cutting people away from your life. Either you are confused or you have too many options with you, but there is something you are upset about. Though you have so many choices, either you are confused, you don't know what to choose, and there is something which is holding you back with the Eight of Swords, though you are actually not bound, but maybe because of the negative experiences, negative energies, or depression or sadness, something is holding you back. Definitely something is holding you back. Either you are not able to decide because of something negative which has happened, but you can come out of it. It is not that you cannot come out of it. Nothing is going to hold you physically, because physically you can come out of it. It is only that mentally you are blocked there and your thought process is blocked there. You're not able to come out of it. Maybe it is because of some past experiences or the negative experiences in the past or in the current situation, whatever it is. But definitely, you either, if it is an emotional thing, then maybe you have many people in your life. Maybe you have many people in your life and you are toying with the emotions of the other person, or, and that is what is, your mindset is like that. You are doing that and you are not able to come out of that, even that situation or that habit of yours. If you do that, if you're in a habit of having multiple partners, multiple girlfriends, multiple boyfriends, if it is a relationship, you're in a habit of toying with the emotions of people, and even if you want to, you're not able to come out of it. That will be for few of you. But as far as the professional part is concerned, in the professional part, I feel that you are being held up by something negative which has happened, and that is why you are not able to decide as to what you should choose now in your life. Okay, so you are in a sort of an undecided position, in a sort of an upset sort of energy. Not a very good energy, but the plus point here is that you can come out of it, because it is not as bad as you think. It is actually not there now. It is just holding you back. Okay, it is not actually there now. That is what I am trying to say. So just come out of it. Choose wisely. Whatever choices you have, if you choose them wisely, and you will be able to choose wisely only when you relieve yourself from these thought blockages. Okay. So just choose wisely, because all negative things, even a snake is there in the option. Wealth is there. This dragon is there. Angel is also there. So you have to choose wisely and do not be stuck up by the mental blockages which you have, or the negative experiences if you have in life. Okay. Now, coming to set number three. Knight of Pentacles, the Three of Wands and the Strength card. Come on. So you definitely have an opportunity. You have an opportunity which is going to give you stability. The only thing is, it is just not moving forward much. It is not a very, it is a very slow moving energy. Okay, but it is a stable energy. Okay, it is not going to go anywhere. It is coming slow, so it will stay also. And with the Three of Wands here also, you are waiting for your ships to come. So definitely you are waiting for something, and you need a lot of strength for this scenario, because perhaps you are tired of waiting a lot. And here one thing is, if you are kind and compassionate, your kindness and compassion and patience only will help you to avail this opportunity, because it is slow and you really can't do much about it. But have the faith, have the trust, because you are ready to embark on a journey. You have the pentacle out there. Somebody is offering you opportunity. So opportunity definitely is there. Ships are definitely there. Okay, the only thing is, the problem is waiting. And you need a lot of patience and strength for that. Okay, so I think the problem with you is, you are stuck in a phase where you're waiting for something. Now, this wait can be of a professional thing. It can be of a personal relationship. It can be of anything. It will be different for different people. But definitely you are waiting for something which you find very good and stable. And it is. And you just need strength to come out of this, or to let this phase pass. But trust me that you will be able to come out of it, and you will get this opportunity. Now, those of you who have chosen set 4, the High Priestess, the 10 of Swords and the 6 of Swords. So for those of you who have chosen this, something has been troubling you, or it has troubled you. You are in this situation in the recent past or in the current energies. With the 10 of Swords, you are totally shattered. You have been cheated and you are in a very painful situation. You don't want to trust anyone now, and you're in a very painful situation. But with the Six of Swords, just see, do not think that everybody has left you. Do not think that nothing is left with you, because you have support. Whatever minimal support it may be, you have near and dear ones with you. You have some sort of financial or emotional support, and you're moving away from the turbulent waters to the peaceful waters in a very guarded way. In a very guarded way, which is right for you. And you're moving away with the support. And the High Priestess is all about, do not act in haste. Be in touch with your inner intuition. And sometimes the best action is not to act. So do not act in haste. If you feel you need to leave a situation, leave the situation. If you feel you need to leave a relationship, leave the relationship. If you feel you need to leave the place, leave it. Whatever your intuition tells you whatever you feel is right for you. Just be in touch with your emotions, meditate a lot so that you can hear your inner voice. Because if you have to come out of this energy, you have to listen to your inner voice, and if you listen to your inner voice, you will get the correct guidance which nobody else is going to give you. Or you can take the advices. I'm not saying don't take the advices, but ultimately you have to follow what is in tune with your own inner guidance or your inner soul. And if you will come out of it, now I'm not saying you actually have to cut the ties with people or actually move to a place or change your job, no, I'm not saying that. It is just a symbolic meaning of saying that you will be moving towards peaceful waters. Either the situation there where you are with the person you are will change and things will go smooth, it can be that, and it can be you literally have to change places or literally have to change the relations or leave people. It can be anything. Okay, so it is just a symbolic way of saying that you will be moving away from the turbulent waters towards the peaceful waters in a guarded way with whatever support you have is the guidance. It can be at the same place if you are able to adjust and other people also come to some compromise, and it may be you have to leave a place. It can be different, and it will be definitely different for different people. So in this reading, it can be about your personal scenario, it can be about professional scenario. It is definitely see, now here I have just left to the cards as to whatever aspect of your life they wanted to talk about. Okay, so everyone has personal as well as professional issues. Now whatever set of cards you have chosen, the destiny has decided you to give the guidance on that particular aspect of your life. Okay, that's all I can say. So I hope it helps at least some of you, and you can definitely see it this in different scenarios of your life. Okay, so thank you, and hope this resonates with you and guides you in some way or the other. Okay, thank you, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.